Kannada News Hour. The rise in internet usage has opened the doors to cyber attackers. Website protection is central to business survival and growth that has been highlighted by data from across the globe. There are still many who believe that their websites are somehow secured against these vicious attacks or that a simple vulnerability scanner is sufficient for security. This lackadaisical approach to web application security combined with the increased lethality and sophistication of attacks is causing the number of attacks to keep rising. COVID-19 has fast-tracked the transition to digital payments across the Asia-Pacific region as consumers opt for the comfort and safety of digital channels rather than expose themselves to disease vectors such as cash. The current COVID-19 pandemic has further accentuated the importance of digital payments among the consumers. At the same time, the vulnerabilities are often caused in the website owing to insecure coding practices, choice of frameworks with known vulnerabilities and security misconfigurations, and the use of insecure themes, plugins, and so on. As per the survey, 75% of organizations intend to shift some of their employees to remote work permanently. This would expose them to potential cyber attacks. India is one of the fastest growing digital consumer markets in the world, with more Indians coming online every day. This makes the country a very lucrative market for tech companies. Chinese tech firms including Alibaba, Tencent, TikTok, owner ByteDance, compete regularly with the likes of Facebook, Amazon and Google to reach Indian consumers. Four of the top five smartphones brands in the country are Chinese and control about 80% of the market, while homegrown brands have only 1% of the market. Let's look into today's headlines in War India. Harvard, MIT sue US government over student visa row. Harvard University and the Massachusetts Institute of Technology are suing the Department of Homeland Security and the Federal Immigration Agency over new guidelines barring foreign students from remaining in America if their universities switched to online-only classes in the fall. Spotify and Apple Music together captured 54% of global music streaming market. The global outbreak of the coronavirus pandemic seemed extremely detrimental and disastrous for most industries. It has improved the overall scenario of the worldwide music streaming industry. According to a new report, the race for subscriptions in the online music streaming market space is heating up with every passing day. Spotify and Apple Music together captured 54% of global music streaming market in Q1 2020. SUSE to acquire Rancher Labs to address enterprise Kubernetes management. SUSE and Rancher Labs has geared to address the open source innovator of choice for enterprise Linux, Kubernetes, edge computing and AI, and create the world's largest independent organization exclusively dedicated to powering digital transformation with open source and cloud native solutions by offering customers and partners extended global reach and unparalleled access to leading technologies to accelerate innovation. Only 18 million 5G subscribers in India by 2025. A recent Ericsson Mobility report says the number of 5G subscribers in India is expected to remain far lesser than expected earlier. The Swedish media and telecommunications company projects 2.8 billion 5G subscribers worldwide by 2025. The figure is counter to the decrease in 5G adoption internationally as a result of the pandemic. NVIDIA eclipses Intel as most valuable US chip maker. It is the first time NVIDIA has overtaken Intel as the most valuable US chip maker. NVIDIA's shares rose 2.3% in afternoon trading on Wednesday to a record $404, putting the graphic component maker's market capitalization at $248 billion, just above the $246 billion value of Intel, once the world's leading chip maker. Google shuts down cloud services in China. The project aimed to provide cloud services to customers and regulatory bodies around the world, Google said it has shut down its cloud project named Isolated Region and added that it was not weighing options to offer its cloud platform in China due to rising geopolitical tensions and the pandemic. Indian Army asks personnel to delete 89 apps including Facebook, TikTok and PUBG. Indian Army has asked its personnel to delete 89 apps from its smartphones including Facebook, TikTok, Tinder, PUBG and Instagram to plug leakage of information, said Indian Army sources. This came days after the government banned 59 apps, mostly Chinese including TikTok, UC, News and Cam Scanner and the news apps including NewsDog and Daily Hunt. Zoom to proceed with legal action against JioMeet. Zoom is considering going for the legal action against JioMeet for copy-pasting of the UI and simply copying its software and closely imitating its user interface. Zoom India head Sameer Rajay has confirmed. Several Twitter users have highlighted the stark resemblance between the two apps in terms of UI and app design. JioMeet has recorded more than 1 million downloads within a week of its launch. COVID brings opportunity to work on digital platform. The lockdown has certainly provided e-commerce a unique environment to expand its footprint, but the first several weeks saw them falter due to lack of product availability as well as breaks in the supply chain. It has also brought out the significance of e-commerce in India. Zoom Rooms to go as a service with hardware partners D10, Nate, Poly and Yealink. Zoom Video Communications has teamed up with four video conferencing hardware makers to launch Zoom Hardware as a service designed to make Zoom Rooms and Zoom Phone more available to enterprises. The hardware and the Zoom bundles gives tech buyers a monthly fixed price that varies by system and support by Zoom. IBM acquires WDG Automation to make its journey into RPA. IBM said that it will acquire WDG Automation for client digital transformation efforts and analytics and artificial intelligence workloads. WDG Automation's portfolio includes RPA automation, interactive voice response and chatbots, as well as technology to create automations without IT help. Finally, the most important thing to consider is that China has set the goal of creating the world's most advanced artificial intelligence and machine learning by 2030. With the data coming from Chinese apps in the country, their most advanced technology is in the works. If the flow of data being collected from India is broken, then the work of their artificial intelligence project will be severely affected. COVID update. The number of coronavirus cases reported from India stands at 7,69,031 with the death toll at 21,144. Daily cases reported in India crossed the 25,000 mark for the first time on Wednesday. Summing up, given that the threat landscape is fast developing, new vulnerabilities are identified frequently and the risks facing a website are changing rapidly. There is no one best security solution or strategy. So, staying updated on the latest in security and continuously tuning the strategy is essential. India has an asymmetric trade relationship with China, its largest trading partner after the United States. India imports intermediate and finished goods from China, including electrical machinery and equipments, consumer electronics, chemicals, pharmaceuticals, and electronic components, among others. Chinese investments into Indian companies have steadily grown in the recent years, and the data shows Chinese investors have put an estimated $4 billion into Indian startups. As of March, 18 of India's 30 unicorns startups valued over $1 billion have received funding from Chinese investors. India already introduced restrictive measures on Chinese foreign direct investments before last month's border clash. Reuters reported that the Indian government is reviewing around 50 investment proposals involving Chinese companies under those measures. Analysts say that any accelerated move from New Delhi to reduce India's exposure to China in the short term may result in supply disruption and higher input costs, making it a costly move for the economy. Let's wind up for the day, but do not forget to like, share, comment and subscribe to War India News Magazine. Please download the War India app for the latest news and updates, which is available on Google Play Store. Stay tuned for more updates. Thank you.